This video, we are going to see how to draw a transition diagram for relational operator. See, this is one specific program. Whatever we take, like, it varies from each and every programming language. So here, these are all some relational operator, like less than or equal to, greater than or equal to. And some programming language use just a single equal to symbol for equal to condition. And this actually denotes a not equal to case. Okay, so this is one specific criteria that I have taken, like it varies from programming language to programming language. Okay, so whenever you want to draw a transition diagram that recognizes these kind of relational operator, then it starts from the starting state. Okay, the name may vary, you can give any name for your states. Okay, it starts from the starting state. If the first element is less than, okay, if the first element is less than, there are three possibilities. Like you have this less than or equal to, not equal to case. Okay, in all the cases, we have to know what is the next element. Like you have three possible criteria over here. So only based on the next element, we can declare whether it is an less than, strictly less than or less than or equal to or not equal to case. So in this case, we have to read the next element. Okay, if the next element is equal to, then we can move to a final state and return. It is a relational operator and the denotation is strictly less than or equal to category. Less than followed by a equal to symbol. So we are going to final state and return it as it is a relational operator as less than equal to. And similar case, if this criteria, if a less than symbol followed by a greater than symbol, then also we are going to this final state and we are going to return it as relational operator not equal to. It is a not equal to case, like it varies from programming language to programming language. That is what I said, right? It varies according to the programming language that I have taken. Like this symbol actually denotes it is a not equal to operator. Or else, if instead of equal to or greater than, if there is some other symbols, then you are going to make it like you are going to strictly say that it is a strictly less than symbol. Okay, so you are going to return it is a relational operator less than. But the problem here is we have read one more character of next lexeme to process this, right? So that has to be returned back. So we use this asterisk symbol either towards here or towards here. That actually denotes we have to move a step back for the next processing. Okay, here it is less than or equal to. Both are involved in a lexeme. Okay, the lexeme is less than or equal to and the token is it is a relational operator LE. And here only the less than is a lexeme and this is a part of next lexeme that you want to read. Okay, in that case we have to move a step backwards for processing. Okay, so this is one step when it is less than or equal to or not equal to case. And similarly, when you have a greater than condition, greater than, you have two possibility. Either it might be a greater than or equal to condition. So you have to read the next element to recognize it. If the next element is equal to, what does that mean? It is a relational operator, reloc. And next one is if it is greater than equal to, we are going to return it as greater than equal to criteria. Okay. And one more possibility of greater than is strictly greater than. If this greater than followed by any other symbol rather than this equal to, then it actually means it is a relational operator of strictly greater than condition. Okay. It is greater than. So in this case, what we have to do, we have look a step ahead to recognize this like token. So we have to revert a step back. Okay, we have to come back and this is a part of the next lexeme that need to be considered. Okay, so we have checked with what is less than or equal to, greater than or equal to, not equal to case. And equal to is a normal thing, right? We can directly check if you have a single equal to, then return relational operator EQ equal to. Okay, so this was the transition diagram that denotes that actually that is the representation for a relational operator. And as I mentioned you, it varies from programming language to programming language. Okay, thank you.